not to retreat to the darkness back of your window. Nothing, look down here, look at me.
Thank you. it quicks up, did it in a ticks up, just like any licks up, what to do? I've got the bottom is up, only cost a penny guarantee. Go and come up, don't worry about it. You rarely stimulate the growth, you can have my oats up, tis you need. A minute stimulating in, soon you'll have to thin it once a week. Penny buys a bottle guaranteed. I've got sample, I've got a smell of the smell. That's a kind of magic. We dab it, gets to be a habit. Soon there'll be an officer, somebody can grab it. That chap with hair, a Shirley's you.
Pardon me, about what's that awful stench?
I feel like
you're
a fucking
awful
stench. You rarely miracle elixir. Anything that slips up, whose brows comes drunk. You rarely when they see a fixer. You can have a pizza of the ghost. Wanna buy a bottle of
this? What is this?
A bottle of this?
It smells like piss.
Rallies are today your boots.
Keep it off your boots, sir. It's right.
Don't get rallied. Rallies use a bottle of. Ladies seem to love it. Lies do too.
I am Mr. Sweeney Todd of Fleet Street, and I have opened this bottle of Pirelli's elixir, and I say to you, sir, that it is nothing but an errant fraud, concocted from piss and ink.
He was right! Better fraud your money down the soup! Ladies and gentlemen, pay no attention to that bad man! Oath to be the first for a magnificent shave!
And furthermore, I have service for no kings, and yet I wager that I can shave a cheek with 10 times the dexterity than any street mountebank. You see these razors?
The finest in England they are.
I lay them against £5 that you will match for me. Do you hear me, sir? Either accept my challenge or view yourself a sham.
These are indeed a fine razors. Instruments like this one seen cannot soon be forgotten. You wager this against £5, sir?
I do.
You hear this foolish Haman? Watch and see how he will regret his folly. £5 it is.
Who's for a free shave?
Me, Mr. Todd, sir.
Who is Todd, sir?
Bring me some chairs, then.
But bring the top, bring the basis.
Well, yes, sir. But this wager only.
Will Beadle Bamford be the judge?
Oh, well, glad as always to oblige my friends and neighbours.
Here.
Ready?
Ready! Ready.
The fastest Sunday shave is the winner. are you looking at a man who had the glory to shave and a bob, Mr. Sweeney, whoever? I beg your pardon, he'll probably say it was only a cardinal law. No. It was a report to shave out a face, to pull out a tooth, required a brace, but not a rabbit. But if you slip, you never escape, you clap on a chain, you rip on a lip, hop in, and that's a lot. To shave on a face, or even a part, without a smart, require a heart. It's in a heart, I show you a chart, I study a starting in my youth. To cover a hair, to trim a beard, to make a bristle, clean like a bristle. This is for early infancy, the talented to me. By God, it take a skill, it take a brains, it take a will, to take a pains, it take a pace. He take out a prize!
The winner is Todd.
Smooth as a monkey's bum!
Sir, I vowed to escape far deafer than my own.
£5.
Yeah, that was
me. Here it is. And may the good Lord smile upon you until we meet again. Bellissime, bellissime, buongiorno, buongiorno, buongiorno.
Oh, before today you pulled me
off. Oh, sir, Mr. Todd, sir. You wouldn't happen to have an establishment of your own?
But he certainly does. Mr. Sweeney told Tom Sauvignon Parlour, just above the pie shop on Fleet Street, sir.
Mr. Todd, it's strange, sir, but it seems your face is known to me.
It is? Oh, well, that's a laugh. It being my uncle's cousin, who arrived from Birmingham yesterday.
But already I have heard Beadle Bamford spoken of with great respect.
Ah, well, sir, I try my best for my neighbours. In Fleet Street, above your pie shop, man?
That's it, sir.
Well then, Mr. Todd, you will surely see me before the week is out.
You will be welcome, Beadle Bamford, and I can guarantee to give you, without a penny's charge, the closest shave you will ever know.
Thank you, sir.
What he said.
Now, and who says the week is out yet? It's only Tuesday.
In business already?
Yes.
Well, I congratulate you, sir. And,
Mrs. Lovett, sir.
Your pleasure, ma'am. Oh, Mr. Todd, I have so much to tell you. I have found the most fairest and loving me that any man could dream of. And yet, there are problems. She has a guardian so tyrannical she's shut up from the human eye. And yet, this morning, this key fell from a shuttered window. Oh, the surest sign that Joanna left means... Well, that's the name, ma'am. And Turpin, that of the abominable parent. A judge, it seems, but like I said, a monstrous tyrant. Oh, Mr. Todd, as soon as the judge goes off to court, I'll sneak into a house and plead with her to fly with me tonight. And yet, when I have her, where will I keep her until I've hired a coach to speed us home to Plymouth? Oh, Mr. Todd, if I could just lodge her here for an hour or two.
Bring her in. Yeah, dear.
Oh, thank you, ma'am. I have your consent, Mr. Todd.
The girl might come.
I must be off. For surely the judge is off to the obeying. A thousand blessings to you both.
Joanna! Oh, the doctor, dear. It's not fight, isn't it? They'll have a back before the day is out.
For a few hours before he carries her off to the other end of England.
That's sailor. Well, let him bring her here and then sit to set her up for a little. That's a filter slip, dear. Now, Mr. T, we'll make a lovely home for her. And then now the poor thing. All those years and little scrap of motherly affection. Oh, some change that I'll be. For if ever there was a maternal art, it's mine.
Mr. Tuck, and to you, Venice, the best of
well, how do you do, senor, I'm sure.
A little business with a Mr. Todd. Perhaps if you give the permission?
Oh, yes indeed. I'll just put them down to be boys. Oh, look! Look at it now! Doesn't look like you'd have kind words, in fact, that's never. Now, dear. How's a bell known to see me poor, eh? Your teeth are strong, I hope.
Oh, yes, no.
Come with me, love.
Mr. Todd.
Signor Pirelli.
Call me Danny. Daniel McGivin's the name. But it's not professional. I imagine you'd pretty it up a bit. I'd like me £5 back now, if you don't mind.
Why?
That's my boy, tuck in.
It'll hold me over till your customers start coming. Then it's half your profits you'll hand over to me every week on a Friday. Charge her alike. All right, Mr. Benjamin Barker.
Why do you call me that?
Well, at least you've got a nice full leather air on you, dear.
Well, to tell you the truth, it's awful hot.
You don't remember me. Why should you? I was just a down and out hired lad you hired for a couple of weeks. Sweeping up hard, like. But I remember these. And you, Benjamin Barker, later transported to Botany Bay for life. So is it a deal or do I run down the street from your pal Bill Bamford? You think you're smart? You foolish a boy. Tomorrow you're stuck in my employ. You understand? You like in my employ.
Oh God! He's got an appointment with his tailor. If he's late, it's my fault. You know, not him.
I wouldn't want to, dear, I'm sure.
Signor! It's late! The tailor, sir! Oh, me wig! Thanks, Mum. Signor! I didn't make a sound out of mind, idiot! The tailor, sir! Oh, you near?
Signor Pirelli has been called away.
Where did he go?
He didn't say. You'd better run after him.
Oh, no, sir. No name so bad in the honest of the contrary. Best wait for him. Yeah.
So, Mrs. Levitt gave you a pie, didn't she, my lad?
Yes, sir. She's real kind, lady. One whole pie.
Whole pie, eh? That's a treat. And yet, if I know a growing boy, there's still room for more pie, eh?
Well, I'd say, sir. An aching void.
Well, then why don't you wait for your master downstairs? There'll be another pie in for you, I'm sure. Owen, tell Mrs. Lovett to give you a nice big top of gin.
Oh, sir! Gee, sir! Thanking you, sir! Thanking you kindly! You're a Christian indeed, sir! Mum!
The man upstairs says to give me a nice top of gin, Mum.
Gin, dear?
Ah, why not?
Justice with mercy, your persistent dedication to a life of crime is such an abomination before God and man that I have no alternative but to sentence you to hang by the neck until you are dead. Court adjourned. It is perhaps remiss of me to close the court so early, but the stench of those miserable wretches in the bar was so offensive to my nostrils, I feared my anus for fresher air might well impair my judgment.
Sir. Well, the adjournment is fortunate for me as well, sir, for today we celebrate my sweet little Annie's birthday. And to have her daddy back so soon to hug and kiss her will be her crowning joy on such a happy day.
It's a happy moment for me too. Walk home with me, for I move for you. In order to shield her from the evils of this world, I decided to marry Joanna next Monday.
Oh, sir, that's happy news indeed.
Strange, when I offered myself to her, she showed a certain reluctance. Well, it's natural in the young girl, I suppose. Now that she's had time for reflection, I'm sure she agreed to my proposal more sensible, correct mine.